Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about Michaelis-Menten hypothesis. Michaelis and Menten hypothesis. Michaelis and Menten in the year 1931, while studying the hydrolysis of sucrose catalyzed by enzyme invertase, proposed this theory. This theory is, however, based on the following assumption. A single substrate and a single product is involved. The process proceeds essentially to completion. The concentration of substrate is much greater than the enzyme in the system. The intermediate enzyme-substrate complex is formed. The rate of decomposition of the substrate is proportional to the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. Michaelis-Menten hypothesis. According to this theory, postulate that enzyme form a weak bonded complex with the substrate. This enzyme substrate complex on hydrolysis decompose to yield a reaction product and a free energy. Now this is Michaelis-Menten equation. According to this equation, V is equal to V max into S divided by Km plus S, where V is the velocity or the speed of the reaction. V max is the maximum enzyme maximum velocity in converting the substrate to a product at saturation, and S is the substrate concentration, and whereas Km is the Michaelis-Menten constant, which represent the substrate at half the V max. Now if you take this graph, here x-axis represent the substrate concentration, y-axis represent velocity of the reaction or the speed of the reaction. And if you can see that at a particular after a particular period of time, the enzyme velocity will be at stationary phase after attaining a maximum, maximum velocity of the reaction. The enzyme will get into a stationary phase, which represent Vmax, that is maximum velocity of the reaction. So if we take an substrate at half the Vmax, this is the velocity of the reaction at maximum, then if we take the half of it, that is half the Vmax, and draw a line in the graph, then it will intersect at the x-axis, which represent Km. So Km is substrate concentration at half the Vmax. So the concept of this hypothesis is to define the affinity of the enzyme for substrate. Michaelis-Menten hypothesis is also known as Haldane's constant. Km is a constant and a characteristic feature of a given enzyme, like for example strength of the enzyme substrate complex. Lower the Km value indicate a strong affinity between the enzyme and the substrate. Majority of the enzyme Km value will be 10 to the power of minus 5 to 10 to the power of minus 2. So this can be used, Km can be used, this hypothesis can be used to calculate the Km after experimentally determine the reaction rate at various substrate concentration. This equilibrium constant, that is Km, when V is equal to half the Vmax, Km is numerically equal to the substrate concentration, or in other words, Km is equal to the concentration of substrate, which gives half the numerical maximum velocity. It is noteworthy that any enzyme substrate system, Km has a characteristic value which is independent of enzyme substrate concentration. Significance of Km and Vmax value. Km is used to measure the enzyme's affinity for its substrate. lower the Km value, higher the enzyme affinity for substrate and vice versa. Km value also provide an idea of the strength of binding of substrate to the enzyme molecule. Lower the Km value, the more tightly bound the substrate is to the enzyme for the reaction to be catalyzed and vice versa. Km value indicate lowest concentration of substrate the enzyme can recognize before reaction catalysis can occur. The enzyme's Km describes the substrate concentration at which the half of the enzyme's active site are occupied by substrate. Km value is also used to measure the substrate concentration when the reaction rate maximum velocity of 50%, that is Km is equal to substrate at half Vmax. The maximum rate reveals the turnover number of an enzyme, the number of substrate molecule being catalyzed per second. This varies considerably from 10 in case of lysozyme to 6 lakh in case of carbonic anhydrase. Concentration of enzyme. Reaction velocity is directly proportional to the concentration of enzyme. Serum enzyme for diagnosis of disease, known volume of serum and substrate taken at optimum pH and temperature. Enzyme is assayed in the laboratory. Temperature. The velocity of enzyme reaction increases with increase in temperature up to a maximum and then decline. Increase in temperature cause increase the kinetic energy of the molecule. A bell-shaped curve is usually observed. Temperature coefficient Q10 increase in enzyme velocity when the temperature is increased by 10 degrees centigrade. Optimum temperature for most of the enzyme is 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. Beyond 50 degrees centigrade, there is a denaturation of enzyme. Next is pH. The most intracellular enzyme exhibit optimal activity at pH value between 6 to 8. Balance between enzyme denaturation at high or low pH and effect on the charged state of enzyme, the substrate, or both. Exception like pepsin, the pH range will be from 1 to 2. Acid phosphatase, pH range is between 4 to 5. And in case of alkaline phosphatase, the pH range, the optimum pH range should be between 10 to 11. Activators. Certain metallic cations like magnesium, manganese, zinc, calcium, cobalt, copper, nickel and potassium. It act in various way, like in combining with the substrate or formation of enzyme substrate metal complex, directly participation in the reaction and bringing a conformational change in the enzyme. There are two categories of enzyme requiring metals for their activity. One is metal activated enzyme, not tightly held by enzyme and can be exchanged easily. Example ATPase, where it required magnesium and calcium and enolase. Another one is metalloenzyme, hold the metal tightly. Example here the metal will be held tightly. Example is alcohol dehydrogenase, carbonic anhydrase, alkaline phosphatase, carboxypeptidase. Other factors like product concentration, even if there is an accumulation of reaction products, generally decrease the enzyme velocity. Next is light and radiation. Exposure to UV ray or a beta ray or a gamma ray or even an X-ray will lead to the inactivation of certain enzymes. Like for example, formation of peroxides. Or when you expose a UV ray, inhibit salivary amylase activity. So these are all some of the examples. Pharmaceutical importance. Enzymes are virtually involved in all physiological processes, which make them the target of choice for drugs that cure or ameliorate human diseases. Applied enzyme kinetics represent the principal tool by which scientists identify and characterize therapeutic agent that selectively inhibit the rate of specific enzymes catalyzed processes. Enzyme kinetics thus play a critical role in drug discovery as well as elaborating the mode of action of drugs. Lineweaver-Brook plot, it is also called as a double reciprocal plot because this is it is just like Michaelis-Menten plot, but in a reciprocal, it will be in a reciprocal manner. It is used to find out Km and Vmax. It is used to determine enzyme internary or ping pong form, and it is used to determine how enzyme is inhibited. So this plot will be used for the detection of how enzyme will be inhibited or in the determination of ternary or ping pong form. Sometimes the enzyme can bind to two substrate at a time. That type of reaction involves in the formation of a ternary complex, where first substrate will bind to the enzyme and another second substrate also bind to the enzyme to form a ternary complex. Now this ternary complex is further divided into two forms. One is ordered random order and another one is ordered form. In case of random ordered ternary complex, the enzyme can bind to the first substrate or it can bind to the second substrate first. Like S1, here the enzyme can bind to the S1 first or S2, that is substrate 2 first. There is no order in this to produce a ternary complex. Whereas in case of ordered form or ordered ternary complex, there should be a order in which the enzyme will bind. Like first S1 should has to bind, and next when it form a enzyme substrate complex, then later the second substrate, that is S2, will bind to that to form a ternary complex. So these are the two forms. One is ordered random ordered ternary complex and another one is ordered ternary complex. Next is ping pong complex or a double displacement complex, in which the enzyme with no ternary complex is formed. That means, see here, enzyme with the first product and a secondary product will give a ternary complex. Here also, in random ordered and ordered, enzyme with two products are present. Whereas in case of a ping pong or double displacement, what happens is that enzyme will bind with the first substrate, produce an enzyme substrate complex, and then that will lead to a first product. Now this first product will be replaced, and then the second substrate will bind to that enzyme to form an enzyme substrate complex, which led to the second product. So in this way, it will displacement of the first product will takes place. After that only second substrate will bind to the enzyme. So these are the two types of reaction which can takes place. So how the plot, reverse plot will be, inverse plot will be seen in case of ternary complex. We see the interception in this place, and the reciprocal plot will be in this form. Whereas in case of a ping pong, parallel lines will be seen. No interception will be seen in this. So this is the difference between the ternary complex and a ping pong complex or a double displacement complex.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.